Hi friends, welcome to OFA Studies. This is part 3 in Azure Data Factory Real-Time Scenarios playlist. In this video, we are going to discuss about incrementally copy new and changed files based upon last modified date. So the main agenda is how to copy files from one folder to another folder within a blob storage, but there is a condition. I should copy only new files or the changed files based on last modified date. So I should be able to do that practically. Okay, so we are going to see this in a practical demo. So prerequisite for these videos are, please watch my Azure Data Factory playlist from the OFA Studies YouTube channel. Okay, so let's go to Azure portal first. So let me explain the requirement here. So this is my blob storage. Here I have a ADF demo container. Inside this container, I have a folder called input. Let me open this folder and show you. Let me minimize this. Now if you closely observe here, I have so many files here, okay? But what I want to do is, I want to take only files based upon the last modified date. So for this demo, what I will say, maybe based upon last two days, that means today is 23rd May, right? So if there is any file for which the last modified date, this column, right? The last modified date is 23 or 22. So in that cases, I want to take those files and then I want to move those files into output folder. So if I go back inside ADF demo, I don't have any output folder right now. So it will create, no problem. It will create the output folder, and inside that folder, I want to place the files. So I want to place only the files where we have last modified date is between last 2 days, 23 and 22. So with that condition, we want to load the files, right? So let's go to our Azure Data Factory. So let me click this author button here, the pencil icon, to open my Azure Data Factory. So let me create a new pipeline. So this is my new pipeline called pipeline 6. Okay, so that is fine. So now here, let me use a copy activity. Let me drag and drop this copy data activity. So here, I should use a source. So let me create a new data set. Azure blob storage type. Let me click CSV format, continue. So first row is header. So let me give a name. Maybe this is DS underscore input folder. This is what I want to give the name for my data set. Let me select my storage location, the linked service for my storage location. So now let me browse for my location and select it. So ADF demo container. Okay, inside this ADF demo container, I have a folder called input. So let me select that. Okay, so I have selected ADF demo container input folder. Okay, click OK here. So this is my source. So as I said, this video is to understand how to incrementally load files, copy files based upon the last modified date, right? So if I go here, what I want is, first thing is, let's select this wildcard file path. So what I want to mention is, inside ADF demo container, go inside the input folder, and there any file with .csv extension. So take all those files, but I want to mention the condition. I want to mention, like, only take last 2 days files and process them. So what I want to do, so let's give a start date here first. So you need to click this add dynamic container. I don't want to hard code the dates. So I want to make them dynamically generated. So because if I hard code here saying like 21st to 23rd, so then this pipeline is always going to work only the files where the last modified date is in between of 21st and 23rd. So I don't want to do that. So I want to do it dynamically. So click this add dynamic content here. And here, right, there is something called add days. So using this function, I want to calculate minus 2 days. So there is something called UTC time, UTC now. So this will give current date when the pipeline is executing, right? Then I want to do minus 2, so that current date minus 2, that is the start date. Okay, then the end date. So here what I want to say is simply UTC now. Okay, so let me search for that function. It is UTC now. Okay, click finish. So this will says UTC now means the day when your pipeline is executing, then minus 2 days. So this is the range. In this range, if there is any file inside input folder where we can see the last modified date as in middle of this range, then it will take all those files and it will process all those files using this copy data activity. So single copy data activity is going to automatically check for the files based upon this last modified settings what we mentioned here, and it will pick those files alone and it will process those files alone. So what I want to process is, I want to take those files into sync location. So my sync location is, let me add a new data set, blob storage, click on continue. So delimited text, okay. So first row is header. So let me give a name for my data set. It might be like ds underscore output folder. This is what my data set name. Let me select the linked service here. So let me browse for the location. It is edf demo container. Okay, so I don't have any output folder, right? So let me type it. So even if you don't have this folder, it will create it. Even if you don't have the path, the data factory will create the path for you. Okay, so let's click OK here. So this is my sync location. So it is saying, okay, you don't have schema because we selected to import schema from the connection. So we need to select this none because we are not pointing to any file. So click OK now. So this is our sync location and this is our source location. And we are dynamically saying, based upon the last modified dates of the files, which files? Only CSV files inside the input folder. Take only those files and load them. So what this will do, it will take only those files. Let me show you that practically. Let me click this debug button and execute this copy data activity. Basically, I'm executing the pipeline 6, okay, which has only one activity called copy data. So now here, if I go to data factory, see, if you observe here, I have only, I think, 3 or 4 files. So this is 23rd May, this is 23rd May, this is 22nd. So 1, 2, 3 files. And also there is one more file here, you can see. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So totally 4 files it should take and it should place them inside a output folder. So let's see here. We can see pipeline status is successful. Now let's click this binocular details button here to see it. You can see totally 4 files processed. Okay. So let's go to our blob storage. Let's go back one step and let's try to see if the output folder got created. We can see the output folder is already created. Let's open this. See, only the files which I pointed before, those files are processed. Not all the files inside the input folder. So this is how you can achieve this requirement. So like this in real time, right? People, what they will do, they want to perform the incremental copy. So what is the meaning of the incremental copy? By this time you might have understand. So in your folder, maybe you are regularly getting files. Okay, so you want to dynamically handle that. Whatever the files came today, I want to process that alone, because yesterday's files and past old data, every file I already processed. So I don't want to process. I want to process only today's file and I want to take that today's file into the output folder. So tomorrow, same thing. So tomorrow's files alone I should take into the output folder. So this way, if you want to achieve this incremental copy approach, so people used to call this type of approach as incremental activity. So you are incrementing the copy, you are incrementing the data load. Okay, so you are not processing entire data once again. So whatever the new files came, only you are taking those new files and processing those files alone. So this kind of scenario in data engineers language, they will say it like incremental data copy or incremental copy data process, whatever maybe it is. So delta copy. So all these keywords are pointing to the same type of scenario. Okay, so hope this given a clear idea how to perform the incremental copy of files from your blob storages using the last modified date column, right? So using the last modified date value, you can perform this incremental copy very easily with the help of this particular field, filter by last modified, inside the copy data source tab. Okay, so hope this given a clear idea. Let's go to our presentation. Yeah, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel and press bell icon to get the notifications whenever I add videos. Thank you.